Please stand. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth on me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth on me shall never die. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore will we not fear, though the earth do change, and though the mountains be moved into the depths of the sea, though the waters thereof do roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Fear not, for I have redeemed thee. I have called thee by thy name. Thou art mine. When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned. Neither shall the flames kindle upon thee. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. I will in no wise fail thee, and neither will I in any wise forsake thee. Good morning to each and every one of you in this service of thanksgiving for departed Sister Leonel Elmina. Let me extend condolences to the family. I know this is a very difficult time for you as family members, but God promises us in his word that his grace is sufficient for us, and his strength is made perfect in all of our weaknesses. And as we understand this, we can declare boldly that his word is true and true to the very minute. So this morning, as we bring our sister's body to this service today, we pray that God's divine blessing, strength, and anointing will be upon each one of us. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Let's turn to our hymnals, to the hymn Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine. Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending bring from above echoes of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story,
This is my song, praising my Savior all day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all day long. Perfect submission, all is at rest. I in my Savior am happy and blessed. Watching and waiting, looking above, filled with His goodness, lost in His love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all day long.
Praise the Lord. You know, the beauty about this song is it was written by a blind woman. And Fanny J. Crosby spoke concerning watching and waiting. How is she going to watch? But she saw things from a different angle. In the realm of the spirit, she knew that the Lord will make everything good for her. Please take your seats this morning as we ask Dr. Antoinette Rock to come. She is special. Thank you.
Thank you very much. A very pleasant good day to everyone. Today, let's give God thanks for His goodness and mercy unto us. Lionel, Leo, or Lee. She preferred to be called Lee, however. Lee was an unassuming and extraordinarily perceptive lady. She was very reserved, she was gentle, and of few but incredibly profound words. She was a very keen listener. She had a remarkable memory for detail, and she was very discerning in speech. Lee lived her life honoring God and always giving thanks for His mercies each day. Her love for children was shown in the carefully and neatly individualized envelopes of monetary gifts for birthdays and other celebratory occasions. I was also a recipient of some of those gifts. She was very empathic that there should be no eulogy for her burial. Therefore, while respecting her wishes, we, the grieving relatives, would like to extend our heartfelt thanks to each of you who took the time out to be here to support her memory and to give thanks for a beautiful life. Special thanks to our kind neighbors and friends who gave support by word and deed. Exceptional thanks and gratitude to nurses Natalie Cassidy, Shanice Eastman, and Keila Robinson. There were nurses from Angelic Hands, who cared for Lee with great compassion kindness, and love. Doctors Rosamond James and Tanya Sargent, thank you. Taxi driver Trevor Stewart, who treated Lee with much patience, thank you. Thanks also to Canon George Knight, who prayed and anointed her before her passing. We would like to say many thanks to the Saunders family, with whom she worked as a nanny for several years and remained with them even when there was no need for a nanny, but as a member of the family. Maggie, to whom she was nanny for many years as well, held Lee in such high regard that she said she could not get married without Lee being present. Lee therefore traveled back to the USA to attend the wedding as second mother. They loved her, and she was very special to them. Last but not least, much gratitude and thanks are offered to the Hope family, especially Aunt Cess and Uncle Dennis, you see sitting here at the front. They took her into their home when she could no longer manage to live on her own independently. She spent the last few years of her life as a member of their family, and there she lived a happy, meaningful life filled with humor. And of course, she was always telling interesting stories. She was a great storyteller, and she had a penchant for historical facts, very detailed historical facts. She had an exceptional use of the English language. We will all miss her tremendously. We will miss her physical presence, but we will always have her spiritual presence with us. Once again, friends and relatives, thank you graciously for your kind support. Thank you.
You have a tribute as well from the Life and Light Apostolic Assembly.
Journey through
Leave.
Well, somebody can say amen or something. Praise God. I haven't heard that song in a long, long time. Oh, I want to see him look upon his face. What marvelous testimony of being able to see the Lord Jesus Christ. Aren't you looking forward to seeing him? What a wonderful day. I heard someone once said, when they get to heaven, that they want to see their mom, they want to see their brother, they want to see their friend. But I want to see Jesus. I want to see Jesus. How can someone love a wretch like me? I want to know. Yeah, the word of God tells us that he so loved us, but I want to know. Because the thing is, and each one of us can testify to the fact, how can God love us? But the Bible tells us his love, it has no limits. The songwriter says it has no boundaries. And we are grateful to God that we have such a heavenly Father that cares so much for us. Amen? Let's stand in the presence of the Lord as we sing the hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Pains we bear, all because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Have we trials and temptations? Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Our refuge, take it to the Lord in prayer. Do thy friends despise, forsake me, take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms he'll take and shield thee. Find a solace there. Oh, bless God, bless God, bless God. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, our hearts are filled with gratitude and thanksgiving that we can bring everything to you in prayer. This morning, oh God, we bring this entire family. Lord Jesus, you know every heart, every life. You know, Lord God, even right now, God, the pain that they suffer, they face. And God, you tell us in your word that your grace is sufficient for us. Your strength is made perfect in weakness. We thank you, Lord God, that you are a sun and shield and you give grace and you give glory. Today, Lord, as I commit this family to you, I pray, Lord God, that your sustaining grace will be upon them, I pray, Lord God, you will undergird them, because underneath of us are your everlasting arms. Lord, we trust you. We put our confidence in you. We know, Lord God, that you care more for us than we care about ourselves. And we thank you, Lord God, today that you loan to us, oh God, our sister, oh God, Leonel. God, we thank you that, God, you allow her to grace, Lord God, this family, to impact this family, and to bring, Lord God, blessing to this family. I pray, Father God, this morning, God, even as we worship you, as we lift our voices in harmony, oh God, as we lift our voices in thanksgiving and praise to you, that, Lord God, you will touch each one of us by your Spirit. So we entrust, Lord God, this service into your hands. And we pray, God, that your grace will be upon us. In Jesus' wonderful name, amen. The scripture reading is taken from the book of 1 Peter. 1 Peter chapter 1. Reading from verse number 3 to verse number 9. 1 Peter.
Blessed be to God and Father of our Son, Lord Jesus Christ, which according to his abundant mercy has begotten us again unto a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled, and that fadeth not away, reserved in heaven for you, who are kept by the power of God through faith unto salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. Wherein ye greatly rejoice, though not for a season, if need be, ye are in heaviness through manifold temptations, that the trial of your faith, being much more precious than of gold that perisheth, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ, whom having not seen, ye love, in whom, though not ye see him not, yet believing, ye rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory, receiving the end of your faith, even the salvation of your souls. Here ends the lesson.
As we remain standing, this particular psalm has been a blessing to multiply thousands of people. And it reads thus: The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Please take your seats this morning as we look into the Word of God. I want to use some verses of scripture from the scripture reading this morning that we have just read in 1 Peter chapter 1. And it says in verse 6, 7, and 8, those are the three verses that I want to look at. It says, "Wherein ye greatly rejoice, though now for a season, if need be, ye are in heaviness through manifold temptations, that the trial of your faith, being much more precious than of gold that perisheth, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ, whom, having not seen, ye love, in whom, though now ye see him not, yet believing, ye rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory." The Apostle Peter had so many things to say concerning his relationship with Jesus. Peter knew difficult times that had transpired in his life. He knew of times when he went off course. And I believe that many a times Peter, in serving Jesus, realized that he had made blunders, that for him, he thought that everything was over for him. But with all of his blunders, Peter came back to the Lord, and the Lord touched his life, and the rest is history. We know how he have blessed us with so many of his words. In fact, these general epistles, 1st and 2nd Peter, have so much to do with Christian living, attitudes, the way of life, to a productive work, to a productive living. I was looking at Lionel's picture, and I want to ask the question, was she a school teacher? Because looking at her face, that thought came across of someone who was studious, someone who really said what she meant and meant what she said. And in being able to share her life with others, meaning that it would have been impactful and a blessing to those who would have come in contact with her. Like Peter, she herself too would have suffered trials, difficulties. Like each and every one of us in this building this morning, we have our difficulties, we have our challenges, we have our problems, we have our hurts. There are so many things that we have that sometimes we think we do not have, or sometimes we think that we are the only ones who are facing what we are facing. What I have come to realize in life is this, that what I am facing, somebody faced already, somebody is facing now, and somebody will face someday afterwards. So we have company as we go through. And listening to Peter's words, verse number 7, he says, that the trial of your faith, the trial of your faith. What I've learned in life is that if you profess something, it will be tried. Like your faith. If you profess faith, it will be tried. It will be tested. Peter's faith was tested on so many occasions. And we will remember very well when Peter, Jesus says, before the cock crow thrice, you're going to deny me. And he denied him. But after he had denied him, there came the time where church history tells us that Peter, in living his life after that moment, never went back. His determination was to serve the Lord Christ until he died. Church history tells us this, that Simon Peter didn't want to be crucified like his Lord, right side up. So he asked to be crucified upside down. He had so much respect for his master. His faith was tried. And can I tell each one of us in this service this morning that our faith will be tried? Our faith will be tried at some time. There is something that presents itself that is far greater than we as individuals will be able to handle in our own strength, that we need the strength of Almighty God to help us. He says, the trial of your faith. The trial of your faith. How many of you love sweet bread? Pardon me. I'm a lover of sweet bread. But I can guarantee you that nobody bakes a sweet bread with a coal oven. No way. If you're going to bake a sweet bread, it must be placed in the oven. The oven must be heated. It must be hot. Because you want to make sure if you're going to offer somebody something that is well cooked and decent, that oven must be heated to a particular temperature so that bread can be cooked well. What about our lives? God knows our lives better than we do know ourselves. And in every situation and circumstance of our lives, we go through stuff that we think God doesn't know about. But brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, God knows everything that happens in your life and in my life. He knows. He understands this. Peter says, the trial of your faith, it is much more precious than gold that perisheth. I had the opportunity to go to Guyana a couple of years ago into the gold mine, Omai gold mine. And there in the gold mine, the process to get an ounce of gold is really tough. I mean, you have to bring the boulders, special trucks, bring in the boulders, special equipment, must crush those rocks. And the rocks not only get crushed to one size, but from one level to another level, they are crushed. Then they have to go through the process of the cyanide. They'll be mixed with cyanide. Then another crushing to the point where it comes to powder. And when it comes down to the powder level, it must go through another level just to get an ounce of gold. There is processes that that stone have gone through so as we would be able to get an ounce of gold. In our lives as well, the Bible says that our faith that is much more precious than gold that perisheth. If to get gold goes through such a process, what will happen to your faith and my faith? There's a song that says, my faith has found a resting place, not in device nor creed. I trust the ever-living one whose wounds shall plead for me. It is important to understand that in this life, we will face situations that we do not understand. It is true that our sister lived a lovely ripe age, 89. She received a blessing, 89 years of age. And not only received a good life, a good great life, but I'm so sure she has passed on many truths, many blessings, many ideas, many thoughts, many things to each and every one of you that are seated here. Her life has impacted you. says is precious. Her life was precious to you. Her life was meaningful to you. I'm so sure when she passed that you sat down and you as a family began to look back over the truths, look back over the things, remember sayings, thoughts, ideas that she released. They were not just born. She would have gone through a process so that she would have been able to share such truths with you. He says, the gold perishes, but our faith, if our faith is in Christ, it doesn't perish. It remains constant. It remains strong. It says, though it be tried, though it be tried, which means that our faith will be tried. I was reading just the past couple of days concerning a man in scripture called Job. Have you heard about Job? Okay. And what is amazing is that Job's life, because his faith was in God. And the Bible says that Job was a righteous man. He feared God. He eschewed evil. But yet, God gave permission to Satan to attack Job. So another one I'm trying to tell you this morning is that Job had not the slightest idea that God was giving Satan permission to attack him. But let me remind you about this, that if God gives permission, God also holds the reins. He holds control of everything. He still takes things in his hands. For us, sometimes we think that death is the end. Sometimes we think, well, every death brings it to conclusion. Brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, we need to understand there is a better life that is coming. The Bible says, Paul declared, the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. The Bible says, this mortal shall put on mortality. There must be a change that must take place within our lives. What happened to this man, Job? The Bible says that when Satan left the presence of God, he stripped Job. Family, sons, daughters, oxen, sheep, everything went in a couple moments' time. From the richest man in the east to the poorest man in the east. And life can sometimes deal us some deals that we must be willing to tell ourselves, in spite of what I lost on planet Earth, there is something reserved in heaven for me that is far better than what I have. You see, the things on earth is temporal. But the things that God has prepared for us, they are eternal. Paul says, for our light afflictions, which is but for a moment, they worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. While we look not at the things which are seen. And mind you, today, people are basing their entire life cycle on what they can see. Brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, there is a life hereafter that God gives to every human being who is willing to say, yes, Lord, change, transform my life. The Bible tells us that Job's life was stripped, not only his children, not only his livestock. But then the Bible says his wife came and says, boy, what you're going through, you don't really deserve it. It is better to curse God and die. And Job said to his wife, thou speakest as a foolish woman. He didn't call the woman foolish. He said, thou speakest as a foolish woman would speak. Do we expect to receive good and not evil? And we must understand in life that things happen. You do not have to be born in a particular family to think that you can evade stuff. Brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, problems come to everybody. We are not immunized. We are not inoculated. They come. And when they come, we must have a foundation that we can rest on. Eventually, Job's friends accused him of sinning, accused him of more or less doing something wrong. But can you remember in the first chapter, God says, this man is a perfect man, one that eschews evil, one that this man fears God. It was God who was testifying about Job. But the Bible tells us in chapter 42 that Job prayed for his friends and God turned the captivity of Job. You must understand that what we go through in life is for a season. Season. A season. And season's over. Just the other day, we had plum season. Now we are in crop season and also crop over season. But they will be over. All of them will be over. All of the seasons. Independence season is coming soon. Christmas season is coming soon. We even have now hurricane season. But these seasons do not last forever. They finish. And I'm grateful to God that all of the things that we suffer on life, pain, hurt, embarrassment, frustration, death, all of these things are for a season. They will change. You may have cried. You may have cried. We grieve. We hurt. But those things are for a season. There's coming a time when change happens. The word says, and Job prayed for his friends, and God gave him twice as much as what he had. God turned things around. It may be a season where we are in heaviness, in a season where temptations may press against us. Seasons where we may feel if we are by ourselves. Seasons we feel that our loved one, you know, is gone and life is over. I encourage people, your loved one passed, grieve, cry. But it's coming a day when we will not need to cry anymore. We'll be reunited. So many of my friends, my family members have passed. I had the opportunity to cry too. I know what it is to cry. But you know, those tears are going to be dried. And God will give us the peace, not only here now, but in time to come, he will give us his glorious peace. He says, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ. It might be found. It will be seen. It will be expressed when we stand before God. Remind you, each one of us will stand before God for himself and herself. I cannot stand for my children. I cannot stand before God for my mother or for my brothers. I must be willing to stand for myself. And what I go through and what you go through in life, brothers and sisters, it is just a time, an examination time, where we write, we allow ourselves to establish and reestablish things on planet Earth. But there comes a time when, like school days for exam, when teacher or the invigilator says, time is up, time is up. We put our pencil down or on our paper and our pens, and we cannot write anything more. And that's the thing about life. What we do today, we must make sure that it is pleasing in God's sight, that it is pleasing to him. Why? Because our legacy outlives our lives. What we do outlives us. People will, even though our sister Lionel has gone, I can tell you this, that people will still say, you know, she was a great woman. She was a wonderful woman. She was a loving woman, a kind woman. Mind you, there are some people too who want to say some evil things about her, because that's how life is. But I'll tell you this, as a family, you will be able to say, she has impacted our lives. Her legacy will live on, impacting your life, and not only your life, but people that you come in contact with, so that they themselves will be able to understand the type of woman she was. I close with this. Whom, having not seen ye love, in whom, though for now ye see him not, yet believing, ye rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory. Peter was looking forward to seeing Jesus. Yes, he walked with him, he talked with him, he ate with him, he knew him. And the greatest joy that Simon Peter could ever want was, one day I'm going to see my Lord again. This morning, I would like to encourage each one of us in this house that we will make sure of our calling and election, that we will not waste our lives. We will not waste our energies. We will not waste what God has given to us to benefit our society, our families, our world. God sent us so that our lives can impact people. And the avenue he uses is to allow our lives to go through the furnace sometimes to bring forth a life that has been purged and a life that can look back and tell people, I know I went through this, but hey, I have come through this. And every individual on planet Earth will have the opportunity to stand before the Lord, because he has created us and he wants us to understand he loves us and wants us to spend eternity with him. One day, Peter is going to be there. One day, Leonel is going to be there. One day, each one of us will stand before God. And he knows our name. He knows our number. He knows exactly where we are at. And if we're going to change things in life, we must be willing to change things while we are here on earth. Pilate made a powerful statement, Hebrew, Latin, and Greek. It says, what I have written, I have written. So we are writing our lifestyle on our life series here today. There comes a time when we will put down our pencils, our paper, and our pens as we stand before the Lord. My prayer is that every one of us, as we stand before him, will have a heart that is repentant and a heart that is trusting him. Come on, me. Bow your heads with me. Our Heavenly Father, you who lives and reigns in might, majesty, and power. Today, Lord, we thank you for your word. We ask you today, Lord, that you will help us, that we will walk before you with an upright heart. Help us, O God, to trust you. We thank you, Lord God, for our sister, Leonel. We thank you, God, that you have given her the capacity to touch these precious lives that are here today. Father, I pray that even as they walk through this life, they will continue to glean, they will continue to harvest from our life tools that would benefit them through this sojourn. Father, we commit them into your divine hands. And we pray, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, will continue to garrison them and continue to keep them. Lord God, as they journey through this life, we ask it in the mighty name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Please stand as we sing the hymn, and can it be? And can it be that I should gain an interest in the Savior's blood? Die he for me who calls his fame, for me who him to death pursue. Amazing love, how can it be that thou, my God, shouldst die for me? Amazing love, how can it be that thou, my God, shouldst die for me? He left his Father's throne above, so free, so in the night his grace, emptied himself of all but love, and bled for Adam's helpless race. His mercy all immense and free, for, oh my God, it found out me. His mercy all immense and free, for, oh my God, it found out me. Love imprisoned spirit lay, fast bound in sin and nature's night. Thine eye diffused a quickening ray. I woke the dungeon flame with light. My chains fell off, my heart was free. I rose, went forth, and followed thee. My chains fell off, my heart was free. I rose, went forth, and followed thee. No condemnation now I dread, Jesus and all in him is mine. Alive in him, my living head, and clothed in righteousness divine. While I approach the eternal God and claim the crown through Christ my own, bold I approach the eternal throne and claim the crown through Christ my own.
We brought nothing into this world, and it's certain we can carry nothing out. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. This corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal shall put on immortality. Then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law, but thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end Christ died and live again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. Today we bring the body of our departed sister, Leonel Elmina. We therefore commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior Jesus Christ, who shall change the body of humiliation and fashion it anew in the likeness of his own body of glory, according to the working of his mighty power, wherewith he is able even to subdue all things unto himself. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. the hymn when the roll is called up yonder.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair, when the silver shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. On that bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection share, when his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the sight, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. The roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, let us labor for the night, for the dawn till setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. Then when all of life is over and our work on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
The hymn, How Great Thou Art.
O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all thy works thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the thou art, how great thou art. tears can take it in, that on the cross my burden gladly gave in. He bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come, out of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim my God how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great.
Him, then we all get to heaven.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansions bright and blessed, he'll prepare for us a place. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. While we walk the pilgrim pathway, clouds will overspread the sky. But when traveling days are over, not a shadow, not a sigh. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Let us then be true and faithful, trust in serving every day. Just one glimpse of him in glory will the toil of life repay. So when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Onward to the prize before us, soon his beauty will be full. Soon the pearly gates will open, we shall tread the streets of gold. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
The hymn, "The Day Thou Gavest, Lord," is ended.
The day thou gavest, Lord, is ended. The darkness falls at thy behest. To be your morning hymn ascended, thy praise shall sanctify.
Let us pray. O God, whose days are without end, whose mercies cannot be numbered, make us, we pray thee, deeply aware of the shortness and uncertainty of human life. Let your Holy Spirit lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days, that when we shall have served our generation, we may be gathered to our ancestors, having testimony of a good conscience in the communion of the Christian church, in the confidence of a certain faith, in the comfort of a holy hope, in favor with you, our God. All this we ask through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, in majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forevermore. Amen. This brings us to the conclusion, the service of thanksgiving and committal service for our sister, Leonel Elmina. I want to encourage you to have a great day as you reflect on her life.
Thank you.
Lord bless you and keep you, make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. Lord, Lord.